Hi, my name is Armin and I am the CEO of Budalgo, a P2Play where... Hi, my name is Armin and I am the CEO of Budalgo, a pay-to-play... I would like to explain to you the advantages of Budalgo. And... Hi, my name is Armin and I am the CEO of... In the next 30 seconds or so, I would like... Hi, my name is Armin and I am CEO of... Oh, come on! You know what? No, this is it. If you want to find out about it, you know what? Find about it yourself.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to day two of the One Voice Conference USA. Are you having a good time? Can we all agree that we have now seen enough of Armin's nether regions? I actually brought him to Spain recently with a group of my team at the villa that we often use for retreats. And we were in the pool. He was wearing less than he was there, which was equally frightening. But I asked my son, I said, "Who are you?" He says, "I'm Baby Shark." And I pointed to Anna. I said, "Who's that?" "That's Mommy Shark." And then I pointed to Armin and I said, "Who's that?" "That's Grandpa Shark." If you see Armin in person in the future, say hi, Grandpa Shark, and he'll know where it came from. I'm so glad to see you all here. I had a great day one, looking forward to a great day today, and we're going to kick it off. We are honored to have as our Saturday keynote, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Valentina Latyna.
Hey, Val, it's Andrew, your agent. Don't forget you have a remote session today at 6 a.m. Wake up.
Too sexy for my love. Too sexy for my love. Love's going to leave.
Hey Val, it's Andrew again. Remember, our Source Connect session is today at 6. Don't forget, the client is in Florida. It will be 3 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. That means in 3 minutes. Okay, break a lip.
Yes, it's a good day for singing a song, and it's a good day for moving along. Yes, it's a good day. How could anything be wrong? A good day from morning till night. And it's a good day for shining your shoes. And it's a good day for losing the blues. Everything to gain and nothing to lose. A good day from morning till night. I said to the sun, good morning, sun. Rise and shine today. You know you gotta get going if you're gonna make a showing. And you got the right of way. Cause it's a good day for paying your bills. And it's a good day for curing your ills. So take a deep breath and throw away the pills. Cause it's a good day from morning till night.
Hey, Valentina, very nice to meet you.
Same.
Can you do me a favor and turn on your camera?
What?
Hey,
Wait, what?
Yeah. pequeñas pipes desde $35 al mes. Así te mantienes conectado con lo tuyo y con los tuyos. Visita tu tienda AT más cercana para obtener detalles. Precio por el plan puede variar disponible con plazo automático, facturación electrónica, impuestos y cargos son extras. Se podría requerir tarjeta de crédito, sujetos a otros cargos, restricciones de uso y otras. Hay que requiere dispositivo compatible y no está disponible en todas partes.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry. I couldn't hear anything. Are you muted?
Hello, hello. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone. How you doing? Good? Yes. Okay. How was the Latino night? Do you guys go? Well, I'm supposed to be the one who's so sleepy. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Okay, so my name is Valentina Latyna. Thank you so much for waking up so early this morning. And why am I a clown? Because just like the clown, we all get embarrassed when we have all the technology in the world. Sometimes we cannot put things together, right? Oh yeah. The reality is that there is always someone who knows more, who knows better, or who knew it before you do. Does anybody else feel that way? Right. Yep. It's human nature to feel that way, but we shouldn't. What we should strive is to be the one who knows more, who knows better, or who knew it before anyone else. Right? That's fine. Okay. Let's see. How are we supposed to recognize this? How? You, blue shirt. What's your name? Andrew. Hi, Andrew. How you doing? Good. Okay, Andrew, can you please share with us the three people that you love and admire the most? Parents, grandparents. I would say something like that. I'm sure most of us would say something like that, right? Let me ask you, has anyone ever told you that you should be the one whom you love and admire the most? See, my mom was not only an actress on soap operas in Colombia, but she was also a single mother of two daughters and two fathers. You know, she was a responsible mother. She gave us different fathers, so. We never fight over that. We each had one. That was awesome. And so when you live that way, trust me, there is no time to motivate your kids. Make them believe they can make a living in a first world country. Not even dare to dream. Saying this is pretty much like not having the chance to dream big, much less believing in myself. My mom did, however, teach me to fight, to persist, and to be the best player in the game. As the great Kobe Bryant used to say, understanding that nothing is ever perfect, you want things to be perfect as they can be. I'm chasing that perfection. Yes? Ah, that sounds good. Let's do that. Love it. Okay, you know, she was paying bills and taking us to school. She was like doing everything as any other, you know, crazy, amazing, talented, and single mother. Okay, so let me speak a little bit on why I say there is always someone who knows more, who knows better, or who knows before. Someone very important to me gave me a while ago what I consider a very influential and valuable gift that I want to share with you all today. And I hope you can learn something else, because I've learned so much about myself through this gift. To this day, I continue to use it in my everyday life and my acting career. I have teleprompter. I have so much technology around me, so this is amazing. Okay. So I'm going to touch on a little bit on why I say there is always someone who knows more, knows better, and knows before. I am going to tell you one of my favorite myths. This is the Odyssey by Homer. Ooh, beautiful. Okay, thank you, Linda. For those who don't know, the Odyssey tells the story of a heroic, strong, imperfect warrior whose inner battle sometimes overshadowed his greatness. His inability to heed God's warnings made him selfish, egotistical, and blind to his true greatness. This is Andrew. No, Henry, sorry. I'm great with names. Sometimes this is applicable when we don't look to others for guidance. Those are our peers, the ones who know more, know better, know before. Odysseus, so you are in context. Is anyone here unfamiliar with the myth? Maybe all of them? No? Some? Ah, thank you, that's good. Well, this is Odysseus, this guy up here. And he was at the top of his game. He was considered a true hero, but the gods felt it was not coming from a humble place. The same day his son was born, they sent him to war. He would again be successful as he saved Troy. Remember that horse made of wood? Well, this is the guy who made it. Ah, got it. Okay, that's Odysseus. Great. So when he fell, he had accomplished what he set out to do. He wanted back home, you know, he wanted to go to his family in Ithaca. But what he didn't know, that it was just the beginning of his odyssey, of his journey. It's only fitting that the word Odisea in Espanol and Odyssey in English comes from his name, Odysseus. So here he realizes that he is great and can be much more, but cannot better himself because of his arrogance. You see, Odysseus truly believed he was the best warrior in all of Greece, and that continued to disappoint the gods. So they punished him to teach him a lesson. Any clue who's this guy? No. Well, for 20 years, the gods cast him and his sheep and crew into the ocean, ruled by the god of the ocean, Poseidon. the evil and ill-tempered god of the sea. For years, he was cast away, struggling against Poseidon, trying to get home. For one of his punishments, Poseidon sent him to so many islands, and of course, every island he had to defend and protect his crew. The last one, the very last island he went to, belonged to the gorgeous temptress goddess Calypso, who kidnapped him and his ship. That's Calypso. We have some sources, so we got some pictures of her. This beautiful goddess Calypso. At the end of what Odysseus thought was only 10 days with this beautiful lady, a goddess, Calypso informed him that it was an illusion, that he had been under her spell for 10 years, long, hard years, during which he went to hell and back, literally. It was then that Odysseus understood that it was his arrogance and pride that cost him 10 years of his life and kept him from what he really wanted, to go to Ithaca with his family. Right, John? Yes. He's so concentrated. Thank you, John. Now, what does Odysseus have to do with us as voiceovers? Any clue? What's this lady talking about? Well, just like Odysseus wasted 10 years of his life doing the same thing over and over and over again, sometimes we make the same mistake. We stay with the same representation that is not giving us any results, right? Others can say, I don't need another technique. I'm fine. I'm breathing fine. Others can say, oh, no, I don't need to upgrade my studio. It's fine. My USB microphone works perfectly. I'm fine. And you know what? Time becomes our enemy. Remember that part when Odysseus was going to hell? Well, guess what? I've been there. I'm sure most of us have been there. Let me explain. Odysseus, he was smart. A voice actor has to be smart, not only for the auditions, but to navigate the business. Odysseus was a warrior. Now tell me if we as actors don't have to be warriors to survive in this industry. Yeah. Odysseus had demons, his pride and arrogance, and thinking that he didn't need anyone else didn't prepare him for the potential rough times. And what about fears? Odysseus had fears. He was scared that he would never get back home. Is anyone here facing fears every day? Is anyone here killing dragons called clients? Anyone here trying to conquer new markets? Surviving bad scripts and embarrassing translations? This is me and Dave surviving in the industry. Those are fears we're facing every day, right? Okay. When I ask myself, when I'm going to finally meet the great agent, right? Or when I'm finally meeting that coach is perfect for me. Or when I'm finally producing that rock star demo. What I mean is, it could be easy to get used to the struggle and become a pessimist. The conversations one has with oneself or with your colleagues. Hey, how's it going?
Man, the same.
It's been slow, huh?
Yeah, right? Are you even auditioning? Haven't you auditioned the last 2 weeks? That's weird.
And the demon we have to fight here is being a pessimist. You start to lose hope. So then the dangerous part becomes that bad things start to look attractive, like lowering your rates because of your fear of losing the opportunity to book the gig, or because you don't know your worth. And that can have bad consequences. Many of my students go like, hey, Val, I'm taking all workshops I possibly can. I join Clubhouse. I have an extra invitation for you. You have an iPhone? Yes, I do have one. My dog's sleeping outside. I soundproof my entire apartment. I just bought the TLM 108. And this gig is paying me $100 in perpetuity. And I'm like, what? TLM 108 doesn't even exist. What are you talking about? You see, I'm not here to tell you your truth, but I can tell you mine for sure. And all the times I was scared to charge what I deserve, I screwed up. I also invested God knows how much to succeed. And still I ended with zeros in my bank account. My point is, know your worth and stick to your rates. Don't let that demon of the fear beat you down and become a pessimist. Remember when I say no more, no better, no before? Yes? Are you guys awake or are you talking to myself? I'm still rehearsing in my living room? What is this? Because our industry exists in a world that is far more complex than it was in the past and has therefore become more difficult to navigate and to adapt to that world. You need to do your research. We need to know more. The world we work in is more volatile. Margins can turn in an instant based on a single piece of news. Where once we had stability because we were working for a radio station with a contract, with benefits, with everything, guess what? We all now facing something. It's called uncertainty. Call it trends, algorithms, social media, influencers, new P2Ps, etc. There are more and more external forces and expectations, in our business. As the number of these forces grows, our voiceover world becomes more complicated and ambiguous. It sends confusing and seemingly incompatible signals. Do I have to have this technology or this technology? Wait, now do I have to become a sound engineer and the accountant and the image of the studio and the relationship person and the janitor and the coffee maker? And please do not forget, be incredibly talented, easy to find, very approachable in order to succeed. So we are all, thank you guys. So we are all, I see you're there. We are all basically in an artificial world more than ever because of 2020. What an unforgettable year, huh? You know, the Washington Post took a poll asking people to describe the year 2020, and the top words were exhausting, lost, chaotic. And my personal favorite, surreal. Wait, does that not sound like an actor's usual state of mind? Exhausted, lost, surreal, chaotic. Now, wonderful things happened too. Please don't take me wrong. Some people got out of that marriage that was a disaster. That's good. Some people in the 2020 also found out the importance of having a spiritual life. It's awesome. Others found out how to connect those cables. And that's what I did too. I had an offer to become a voiceover director for one of the big five companies in the American information technology industry. Just Google it. and hell. I did it. It was my first time directing a massive project. And this not only gave me a highlight on my resume, but also the biggest lesson as an artist. My industry has changed, and I have two options: to reject it or to learn and moving forward. I want to be the one who knows more, who knows better, and who knows before. Because in a world that evolves, someone that does not advance regresses. This is a quote from Jorge Angel Libraga. He's the founder of Neacropolis. Check him out. I'm going to say this in Spanish real fast. En un mundo que evoluciona, el que no avanza, retrocede. I'm learning to take responsibility in a world with new demands on all of us, which means we all need to take control of our business, starting from our own studios. If the voiceover industry is going to become a high reliability industry, we need to tailor our work to meet the new complexity. But the pandemic is not the only crisis we're facing. For years, I have heard this, the AI is pushing out human voices. And if we let this fear drag on, our resilience gets lower. We lose hope. We think about dropping out of the industry. So let me ask you, what are you doing to be prepared for the new future? Or do you just wish it would just end and then we could get back to normal? I don't wish things to get back to normal, thank you. Otherwise, I haven't learned anything. The pandemic and this crisis of the AI is changing the world, and this technology is uniquely equipped to thrive in this new world. Some companies and some voiceover talents have reinvented themselves through this crisis, and the resilience stocks are higher than ever. Someone's like, hey, that's me, I'm that group. It's not just how we behave during the crisis, it's how we improve our systems so they are more resistant to the next crisis. We need more responsible leaders in our industry, in all areas: talent, casting directors, right? Agents, sound engineers. Okay, so I'm gonna finish this, and sorry about auditions. Oh, here it is. Oh, hi, auditions. And that's Athena, right behind him, holding a Medusa, how do you call that thing? Shield? Beautiful. My example of Odysseus could be the worst example of the ideal hero, because he was just another simple mortal, just like us, pursuing the impossible. And he got a lot of visits from Athena. She is the goddess of war, science, and wisdom. And he rejected her several times. I mean, he was right. He was the best warrior in all of Greece, plus thousands of soldiers. What else he would need? Let me be clear about the importance of wise teachings, which can come in many different shapes. A masterclass, an agent that believes in you, or a simple smile from the new friend you're meeting this weekend. It is also wise to recognize how strong you have been, how wise you were to not listen to that voice. Quit. If you don't have an agent in this conference, this is awful. No, you didn't. You're more than that, because you know, we all know, the show must go on. We all sit in here alive. We take for granted the fact we're breathing. But we're breathing. Isn't it amazing? Barely, because the face mask, but we're breathing. We are a group of blessed friends, survivors of the pandemic 2020. Amen. And we are part of history because we keep moving forward. No one did it on their own. We are all together on this path, right? Well, to end my story, this is finally Odysseus getting home after 20 years. His son recognized him, and so did his dog. If you guys want to take the time to see better about the myth, it's beautiful. If you're a pet lover, you'll love this part as well. Because as soon as Odysseus get to Ithaca, his dog was really sick, of course, missing his master. And he was just waiting for his master to come back and rest in peace. They finally, you know, got together with his beautiful Penelope, his wife, and they live happily ever after. No, they probably don't. Penelope was asking about Calypso too.
And how's she doing? Is she better than me?
He was back to his island, Ithaca, as he promised. Now, in what part of the story are you? Saving a dream? Facing insecurities? Finding the beauty, the eternal, the justice? Or do you feel more like Josefina, the clown? That's her name. You better put names to your clown. I'm not the only one here. Calm down. She's funny, right? Yeah, she makes me laugh too. Yes. Josefina is the one scrolling on Facebook at 6:30 a.m. instead of checking her email for invoices and, you know, auditions and doing real things. No. She can find an agent just in case you can refer her to somebody. That'd be great. She's the one on Instagram, hashtag living my best life. She's the one who says, oh no, I just need one read and I'll be fine. Don't worry, trust me, I'm fine. I love her. She's my shadow. And I have to take care of her. That's mental health. Because with all her faults, she reminds me, I have to have fun. And I do this because this is what I love. But right now, here, I choose to be the hero. Yes, because I was the one who took a plane on May 19, 2010, to the United States for the first time without friends or family in LA. No car, no English at all. Yeah, this is worse. This was even worse. All my savings for 14 years in my pocket, and my heart absolutely broken by the cheating boyfriend I left behind. I choose to be the hero, the one who 2 days ago, well, 3 days ago, was at Disney Studios recording her first original animation in English. But wait. People is leaving. Why? I'm not the only hero here. So I want you guys, please, take a look under your seats. And if you find something, if you don't, just feel free to share with some of your friends. Open it, and let's face the true Odysseus, the true hero. Hold on, this is a beautiful picture for Josefina. Not for me. Okay, everybody smile. Hold on, where is Jay? Okay. Oh, great. Okay, my name is Valentina Latyna. You guys enjoy. Welcome to the One Voice Conference. I want to thank real fast to all of you, of course, for attending this morning. For all the people who's joining, did I drop something? Joining online, and of course, J. Michael Collins, thank you so much, and all his crew his shoulders and everything to make this happen, to my handsome husband back there, my daughters and everyone else. Thank you, guys. Welcome to the One Voice Conference 2021.
Valentina Latyna, everybody. Get some refreshments, relax. Next session start in about 10 minutes. Thank you all.